Yo, what's up, people? Gerisu Weeaboo here. In this video, it's just going to be a quick roundup of the spring anime that I've been watching. So, let's go. Appare Rannam. Now, I saw people posting about this on Instagram before it aired, and people were saying, oh, it's meant to be like the new Dr. Stone and that. But I ain't seen no new Dr. Stone. I saw Steel Ball Run, the anime. That's what I saw, you know. The shit was like part 7, like what the hell? And I'll be honest, like I switched off halfway through the first episode and then it got postponed. I was like, cool, so yeah. I don't know, if I see people posting about it, you know, when it starts airing back in summer and people saying it's really good, I might pick it back up, but other than that, nah. And to be fair, it probably would have been a good anime. It probably is a good anime, but you know, there's only so many seasonal anime I can pick up. And you know, I'd already picked up a few, so that one just kind of got dropped. The Millionaire Detective, Balance Unlimited. I didn't really get the hype for this. I see a lot of girls like fangirling over Daisuke Kanabe, and I've watched the first ep, I didn't really like it. I watched the second ep, I was like, okay, I was just being too silly, it's actually really fun. And then of course that got postponed, so it's gonna start airing soon with the summer lineup of anime. BNA, Brand New Animal. This anime is actually so sick. Like, I think it's really good. I mean, if you've seen Promare, like, it's the same studio, Studio Trigger. Like, it's kind of like the same story, but it's just, you know, a lot more in depth because they got a whole 12 episodes. Promare was like, what, 2 hours or something? So yeah, I think it's a really dope series. It's just exciting. Michiru, she's like a fun MC. And some of the reflections between like normal society and like the anime city and shit. Like, it's just so cool and that. And you know, Trigger does all them crazy colors and shit sometimes. Like, it just be fun, you know. I just got into that anime. Like, it's, you know, it definitely ends on the 12th ep. Like, it's nothing, you know, just as like a new anime, it's just something fun to watch, you know. It's nothing groundbreaking, like, it's nothing amazing. But I just had a lot of fun watching it. It's gonna come on Netflix soon as well. Hopefully people check it out and enjoy that, you know. Fruits Basket Season 2. Yeah, Akito, she's a bitch, man. Oh my days, like, crazy yatty, like, got the mad god complex thing, like. Now, I've never read the manga or watched the original anime. My first experience with the series was last year when they started airing it. So, you know, this is all fresh for me. This is all new. And I'm liking it still. Like, it really picked up a lot in season 2. Like, obviously I can tell that Toru's trying to break the curse now of the whole Zodiac thing. It's good still. I fuck with Fruits Baskets. Gleipnir thing. Yeah, I think it's pretty good still. I don't think it's the best of the season though. Like, don't get it twisted, man's enjoyed every ep, but I just don't think it bangs like some sick anime, but it's cool still. The whole ecchi horror thing was kind of sick. And like, you know, when my man Shuichi fused with like a different thing. Obviously, I'm not trying to spoil the anime for people who ain't seen it, but it's exciting still. But yeah, as cool as Gleipnir was, like, it didn't really leave no impression on me. Like, it's fun to watch, but you know. Okay, Tower of God. I know there's a big following for the manhwa. I know a few people that read it, and I hear so many good things about it. And I've no doubt in my mind it's a really good story. I enjoyed the anime, watching it weekly, it was fun. Nothing over the top for me personally, even that twist towards the end. Like, yeah, it was sick, but like, you know, it still feels kind of mid for me personally. But I know that the story goes on and whatnot. But them 13 episodes, they didn't gas me to want to start reading though. I did check out the webtoon like a few weeks before the anime started airing. I thought the drawings were awful. Like, no disrespect to the man's work, but I thought the art was weak. I didn't read past the first episode, like, but when I watched episode 1 now, like, I could see how the art style reflected the manhwas, you know. And I heard the art improves over time. Obviously the story's most important thing. It's alright if art's kind of dead, but like, yeah, Tower of God thing, it's cool still. I'm more excited for God of High School, but you know, Tower of God thing cold as well still. Yesterday World Tate, I really like this anime still. It's complicated, you know. It's one of those shows where it's like the main guy likes this chick, but she don't really like him, she likes someone else, and then there's a thing that likes the main guy, and it's one of those type of shows, you know. But the way it was done, just the way, slice of life type of energy, you know, like, there's bare scenes, man's just working in 7-Eleven. But yeah, there was like a lot of scenes that, you know, became really awkward moments, and this is relatable still on a lot of levels. I think in life, anytime when you like someone or someone likes you, there's always going to be like frictions with other people and that. But the way the anime captured that, I thought they'd done it just sick. It's like, on paper it sounds boring, like, but I don't know, every week it kept me entertained though. I kept coming back for more every week. I never thought like, ah, oh, that's dead. Like, it's a good anime still. So, you know, if you're into like, if you want to see about relationships and shit, like, yeah, check it out still. Kakushi Goto. Just the soft art style, the witty comedy and that. Just like Goto being a good guy for his daughter. There's just so many little nice things that got encompassed in it. I got really took a liking to it. And then there's like this whole little dark little twist thing that's going on as well. Really good anime still, really good. If you like manga and all that, interested in how it gets made and that as well, it's good. Obviously, this ain't got shit on Bakuman. That's like a proper shonen-esque story, Bakuman. This is more like slice of life, jokey thing. But, you know, it's still interesting as well just to get like some more inside knowledge on the industry, you know? The new season of Baki. I thought it was lit, obviously. Like, seeing Muhammad Ali Jr. do his thing and that, seeing Baki pipe up Muhammad Ali Jr. and that, like, it was dope still. Yujiro just being a bastard as usual, just being funny, arrogant, like, that shit was dope still. Them Chinese man thought it was on smoke, though. Like, they proper try to say we can do a clean victory, and they go worked, like, disgustingly. So I thought that was joke still. Yeah, Baki's always dope still. Like, it's just entertaining, you know. I love them bits in Baki that make me cringe as well, like when a man breaks their arm or bones poking out the hand and that. Oof, horrible still, but I do like it. And finally, the last anime that I watched from the spring season, which I personally think was the anime of the season, Kaguya-sama Love is War season 2. Come on, baby, that show is so lit. It's so lit. Honestly, yeah, okay, so boom, I started watching season 1 weekly, innit, like, that aired winter 2019, I believe, and I just thought it was kind of dope. I just loved the whole vibe of it, like, slice of life, student council thing, you know. It's, I don't know, it don't really sound like it should bang, but the way they do it, it just bangs, like, I can't explain it. So when I see that season 2 was coming back now, I was excited. I was like, yeah, man, I kind of missed all them characters, like, just how bubbly they are, you know. And yeah, just because of what's been going on in the world as well, like, you guys already know how crazy it's been. Just having that to watch every Saturday was just nice, a nice little pick-me-up. It's like every time I turn it on, I forgot about the world. I was just totally sucked into the shenanigans of the gang and that. Like, really fucking fun still. But no, Kaguya-sama season 2 is lit though. See, Lino, yeah, when Lino come into it, I did not like her at all. I was like, this thing is way too strict. Like, she's gonna fuck up the whole show. I thought it was gonna make it all about her. But I'm so happy and glad that she became like a nice asset to the team. And for a whole second season, I'm guessing the whole manga is kind of built on like such a repetitive kind of formula of, you know, these two wanting the other to confess their love for them and not doing it. But it just works. Like, it's not repetitive, it's not boring, like. But yeah, for me personally, that's the show I look forward to most each week, because I knew I was guaranteed to like just have fun, you know. As exciting as Tower of God was, I had more fun watching Kaguya-sama season 2. But that's just me, innit. Anyways, guys, I hope you are all excited for the new anime coming out in summer. Really excited for God of High School. We've got season 2 of Fire Force as well, and a couple new ones, like. So yeah, a lot to look forward to. But yeah, guys, did you agree with my list? Let me know down in the comments. Like, tell me what kind of anime you've been watching in spring. Please drop a like if you liked the video. Hit subscribe if you ain't. I'm gonna do more content soon. And yeah, catch you in the next one. Peace.